Good morning, students. In the previous videos, we have discussed how the statue of prince helped the needy persons with the help of sword. Now, in continuation of that, we will continue this story. Now, the prince had given his both eyes for the needy person, for the playwright or the match girl. Now, the swallow came back to the prince. "You are blind now," he said, "so I will stay with you always." "No, little swallow," said the poor prince. "You must go away to Egypt. You should go to Egypt." "No, I will stay with you always," said the swallow. But the swallow said that he would live there always, and he slept at the prince's feet. All the next day he sat on the prince's shoulder and told him stories of what he had seen in his dream. Whatever he had seen, he told all these things to the happy prince. "Dear little swallow," said the prince, "you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. You have to tell me wonderful things, that is the suffering of men and women. There is no misery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, or tell me what you see there." "You have to fly over the city, and after that you have to tell me what is happening there." So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses, while the beggars were sitting at the gates. Whatever he saw there, that the rich people are making happy in their beautiful houses, beggars are sitting at the gates, and he flew into the dark lanes and saw the white passage of starving hungry children looking out listlessly. This he said, and he also saw the children who are suffering from hunger. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to dry and keep themselves warm, because it was cold, and so they were trying to warm themselves. "How hungry we are," they said. "You must not lie here," shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. After that, they went into the rain. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. "What he had seen," he told the prince. "I am covered with fine gold," said the prince. "You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor." Now prince wanted to help the needy person, so he said to swallow that you can take the leaf of the gold from my body and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold the swallow picked off, till the happy prince looked quite dull and gray. And now happy prince looked dull and gray. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor. The children's faces grew rosier and they laughed and played in the street. "We have bread now," they cried. And on the other hand, the persons to whom the happy prince helped, they became very happy. They are laughing and playing, and they are crying that they have bread now. Then the snow came. After the snow came the frost. The street looked as if they were made of silver. Because of the snow, the streets are covered with snow. Everybody went about in furs, and the little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. They were skating on the ice. The poor little swallow grew colder and colder, but he would not leave the prince. He loved him too well. He loved too much to prince, so he did not leave him. He picked up crumbs money pieces outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking, and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. And now he was also trying to keep himself warm. But at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. "Goodbye, dear prince," he murmured. "Speak softly. Will you let me kiss your hand?" And now he said to the prince that I think that I have to go. So allow me to kiss your hand. I am glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little sorrow. The prince thought that he is going to Egypt, but he said that he was not going to the Egypt. He is going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not? And he kissed the happy prince on his lip and fell down dead at his feet. At that moment, he died. A curious crack sounded inside the statue as if something had broken. There was a curious crack. The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right in two. It had broken into two. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in company with the town councillor. As they passed the column, he looked up the statue. Dear me, how shabby, how dirty the happy prince looked, he said. Next morning, when the mayor was walking with his town councillors, he said that this statue looked very dirty. So, क्या करना है? How shabby indeed, cried the town councillor, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went. They pulled the statue of the happy prince. Little house heavy. The ruby has fallen out of his bird. His eyes were gone and he is golden no longer, said the mayor. In fact, he is little better than a beggar. It looks like a beggar, so it should be moved from here. Little better than a beggar, said the town councillor. Thoda sa better hai beggar se. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet. There is a dead bird, continued the mayor. We must really issue a proclamation announcement that for the birds are not to be allowed to die here. And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. So they pulled down the statue of the happy prince, as he is no longer, because he is no beautiful and no useful. So the statue of happy prince was pulled down. Then they melted the statue in a furnace oven, burning. What a strange thing, said the overseer of the workmen at the foundry. This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace. We must throw it away. So they threw it on a dust heap where the dead sorrow was also, and his heart, his dead lead also thrown into the dust, where the dead swallow was also lying. Bring me the two most precious things in the city, said God to one of his angels. Now he is there. The God said to his angel to bring the two most precious things in the city. The angel brought him the leaden heart and the dead bird. That is the swallow. You have rightly chosen, said God, for in my garden of paradise the little bird shall sing forevermore, and in my city of gold the happy prince shall praise me. So in this way they died. So students, I think you are able to understand this beautiful story, a very beautiful story. Thank you, students.